Well, the day before was just like any other day, looking after my toddler and baby at the time. I felt a little bit run down, a little bit tired, nothing really out of the ordinary. Around dinner time, I started to feel a little bit sick. So I just got an early night, put my head down, and thought I'd feel better in the morning. As soon as I opened my eyes, I had the most searing pain in my head. It was the worst headache I've ever had in my life. It felt like a pressure building up from the inside out. The pain was in my eyes, it was in my ears, in my throat. It felt like it was everywhere. I had severe sensitivity to light, couldn't look at my phone screen. Yeah, it was quite scary for a while, not knowing what was going on. I was having some seizure activity as well. I was having what they call myoclonic jerks, which is like the jumps that you get when you're falling asleep. I had a little look on Google, as you do. Google came up with, initially, meningitis, which I dismissed because I've never known any adults to get meningitis before. I think people are under the impression that it's mostly children. So yeah, I dismissed that, as well as I didn't have that characteristic rash that everybody knows, the glass test. So I thought, oh, it can't be meningitis. I spent a long time, actually, just trying to convinced myself that it was nothing serious, and that I would just get better throughout the day, which I didn't. I did put into Google the worst headache of my life, which did immediately pop up with meningitis. And I also did a lot of searches where I said, when do I seek medical attention for a headache? It did come up when it's been the worst headache of your life, if you have sensitivity to light or a very stiff neck, which I did. I couldn't turn my head to either side or up or down. The symptoms started when I first woke up, really. I think I left it a good 6 hours to try and improve. I was in bed the whole time, but I was just progressively getting worse, and the seizures were becoming more frequent and closer together. So I decided to call 111. They asked me to go to out of hours, and obviously being unable to get out of bed, let alone lift my head up off the pillow, I couldn't make it to out of hours, even in a taxi, which they suggested. They had a paramedic turn up in a car, and he did some tests, just my blood pressure and my pulse and temperature, which all came back relatively okay, but he was still concerned about the headache, the stiff neck, the light sensitivity, and the fact that I was having these seizures, which I'd never had before. The doctors were very, very busy in A&E. There was a lot of people going past and not a lot of people coming into the room to check on me, which I found very frightening. I felt very alone at that point. I didn't have anybody with me, so I was on my own, not knowing why I was having these seizures. At one point, my hand seized up like a claw, and I was trying to phone my mum at the time to, you know, tell her that I was in hospital, and I couldn't even move my hand. It was just fixed in that position, which is very frightening. The doctors didn't really take it seriously until I had a lumbar puncture and the results came back as meningitis. Having a lumbar puncture was quite scary. You have to stay very, very still and lay on your side and not move, which is very unnatural. You want to breathe and fidget, and you have a local anaesthetic which stops the pain of the larger needle going into your spine, but it's still very uncomfortable, and you can feel the needle moving around in your back, and you're led there for quite a long time while they get the amount of fluid that they need. It's quite a slow process. It's like a drip, drip, drip. I was in and out of hospital with the meningitis for 2 weeks. I was there for 1 week initially, and then I was sent home for 2 days. I was readmitted because of worsening symptoms, they weren't getting better. And then I was in for another week in the hospital. It took quite a long time to recover. I was very dizzy and spaced out, slightly worse vision. The tinnitus got a lot worse, so I regularly have quite a loud ringing in my ears all the time. I find I'm quite sensitive to loud noises and bright lights still. I would say don't wait with seeking medical attention. It took me a long time to pluck up the courage to call them. I felt like I was wasting their time. Had it been bacterial meningitis, I may not be here now. If I had waited for a rash, I may not be here. It's very, very scary. It happens very, very quickly. And I think people need to take it more seriously when they have any of the symptoms related to meningitis.